2. We have ignition, and we have liftoff of the United Launch Alliance Atlas V rocket with
There goes, new from overnight, ULA launching its Atlas V rocket after a few delays. It took off from the launch pad around 6:13 this morning, actually the second launch this week. The news station Sydney Cameron has more from Cape Canaveral.
We had liftoff just before 6:15 this morning. Atlas V taking off from this launch pad right across the water. It was a beautiful sight to see right as the sun was coming up. I have Chris Prettigrew with Lockheed Martin with me right now. What was it like to see that launch?
Well, this was my first Atlas V launch, so it was just incredible to see the pre-dawn light mixing with the rocket. It was incredible.
And I understand that we had a couple of delays. Were you at any point afraid that this wasn't going to happen?
No, so the delays were pretty minor, and they come up from time to time, so it's safety is priority number one for ULA, so I was just glad to see it go off.
Exactly. And talk about what Atlas V is taking into space right now.
So AEHF-5 is on its way to its orbit, and that's a secure, protected communication satellite for the president and his top advisors, as well as warfighters on the ground at sea. It's just an incredible asset that they need to be able to talk with each other securely. It's anti-jam, and our allies use it too. It's Canada, United Kingdom, Netherlands, and Australia should be joining soon.
So very important, and it's going to join a ring of four other satellites, correct?
That's correct. So AEHF-5 joins the constellation of four other satellites. A sixth will be added early next spring. So it's adding much needed capacity for the warfighters so they can send images, real-time video, voice, text, all the things that you and I take for granted with our smartphones.
Thank you so much, Chris. It's going to take about 5.5 hours before Atlas V deploys that satellite, and then it will take even more time for that satellite to go into orbit, but crews will be making sure that that satellite is working properly once it is deployed. Reporting on the Space Coast, Sydney Cameron, Fox 35 News.